coronavirus has actually been around for a very long time. It wasn't until 2003 when a unusual virus came and swept Asia, started in Guangzhou and then went to Southeast Asia and then spread to the world, and that was called SARS. I was responsible for the scientific response to the SARS crisis in Southeast Asia. The SARS virus occurred jumping from an animal called a civet to human. Upon sequencing, that was found to be a coronavirus. The same thing happened with the COVID-19 in Wuhan. With sequencing, we knew that COVID-19 arose from a bat coronavirus and probably went through a series of other vectors to get into the humans. Just like the SARS, the COVID-19 epidemic occurred at the same time as a concurrent influenza epidemic. And the symptoms are very, very similar: fever, cough, shortness of breath. The mortality rate for influenza is about 1/10 of that of the COVID-19. The key mortality that happens is an acute respiratory distress syndrome, which is both because of viral damage and also intense immunologic response that occurs in some people. It's spread by coughing and sneezing. Therefore, the number of individuals that you might infect, it's estimated to be around 2.6, which is significant. From the time of contact to the time of symptoms is about 4 and 7 days. And it's been estimated that the time of excretion of the virus, how long might they be passing the virus, is about 14 days. Science is moving forward to try to find a solution to this COVID-19 epidemic. Unfortunately, vaccine development requires approximately 12 to 18 months, not only to prove the efficacy of the virus, but also to scale up to the millions and millions of units that are necessary to make vaccines work. There have been antivirals that have been tested for SARS. We need to have animal models to test these antivirals in a real-time manner in the developmental cycle. COVID-19 enters human cells through the human ACE2 receptor. The mouse ACE2 receptor does not take up COVID-19. Scientists at University of Iowa had developed an animal model for SARS, which put in the human ACE2 receptor. It means that we now have a model for infection, and we can trace whether or not these drugs will make a difference. To this end, I'm very proud to say that the Jackson Lab will be the premier provider of this mouse to the research community. We are doing everything we can to monitor the situation, both locally and nationally and internationally, and we'll be pulling all stops to make sure that we will be as safe as we possibly can.